Hello good people, welcome and welcome back to my channel. It's your ID Lady Eva Soila. So in today's video I'll be talking about the essential things that I can't live without. Yeah, so stay tuned and enjoy the video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share. Let's make this family grow bigger and better. The first thing on the list is my watch. Like if you've noticed in all my videos and like whenever I'm dressing up to go somewhere, I must put on my watch. It just completes my outfit. And most of all, I just learned how to be looking at my watch when I was really tiny. So like when I was about 3 years or two, I could read a watch nicely, like the clock face of the watch, not the watches that already like tell you what time it is exactly. Yeah, so I'm a lover of time and I must have my watch with me regardless, come rain, come sunshine. So that's my first thing. So next is mouthwash, like whichever the brand, but I'll prefer one that whitens teeth and pure fresh breath, of course. Yeah, so I always have mouthwash simply because I love eating chocolate so much. And there goes my third thing, like I'm also a lover of chocolate. So like I take too much chocolate, not junk, mostly it's chocolate. So I like having like mouthwash with me so that whenever I eat and I'm done, I like just gargle and I'm good to go. So my next thing should be bar soap. I know I'm weird, like I can't live without bar soap, honestly. I rather live without any other soap. Bar soap majorly because first, my skin is prone to acne. I know it's not as healthy using bar soap on your skin because it's a little bit harsh, but honestly I think bar soap just works for me, especially the fact that bar soap has a drying effect. So if my skin is oily, it just dries it up. So I find it a good thing. But if you have dry skin or normal skin, no, bar soap is not a good thing to use on your face, because bar soap is really harsh on your face. But to me, I can't live without bar soap, honestly. I have like makeup removal things, okay, basically let's say the micellar cleansing water. I have washes for facial washes for the face, of course. I have shower gels, but at the end of the day I just have to have bar soap with me. Like it just makes work so easy. It helps me with my acne. Like at least I'm 80% sure using bar soap, me, I'm just good to go. Yeah, so that's my major thing. And next goes a lip moisturizer. So whichever it is, okay, this one is for Nivea. So like I think in a number of videos I've shown you, I like the Oriflame lip balm. It's so nice because it's made of beeswax and it's like really soft and it's scentless, so I just like it. Or Nivea, this one has like a red color little bit. Yeah, so I must have a lip moisturizer. I don't like situations that you find you have like cracked lips or dry lips and you're just there storytelling. That's not me. Yeah, so I must have a lip moisturizer. So next is a travel size deodorant. So actually I love deodorants from Miniso, sorry. So but this one I got it from just a random shop in town in the CBD. So I always make sure like I have deodorant, because deodorant, it just makes you feel like you're always fresh. It's like you've just taken a shower, like kidogo you just feeling fresh. So I'll make sure I always have deodorant with me. So next is water. Oh my god, I can't live without water. Now this is the last thing, like I literally take too much water in a day. You know, the fact that water is hydrating, water just freshens you up. It just makes you feel like you are rejuvenated and you got energy to like work, and everything about water is just good. So me and water, best of friends. Yes. So the next thing, you all know I'm a foodie, that's for sure. So like me living without food, not really. So here's my food. Like I always have food. I have to have water. Okay, but I rather, okay, don't say that I should say without food, no. But I prefer water to food. But of course, I can't stay without food, honestly. I always literally feel hungry, like, okay, oftenly, let's say. So I'm having some matoke, some rice, and avocado. Life without avocado, you can imagine. It's the craziest. So like basically I love fruits, so I'll either have, like now I'll have matoke, avocado, rice, and some stew. Then at times, fruits, that's a thing also I never lack in my day-to-day activities. Like I must eat fruits, whether I'm indoors, whether I'm outdoors, like I have to eat fruits. Yes, that's how crazy of a foodie I am. Yes, so next is my phone. Like normally, who cannot live without their phone? Like nowadays with your phone, you can do so many things, starting from business. Like your phone is your source of entertainment. Like nowadays I've just noticed that society is becoming weird, in the sense that most people suffer depression actually, but because we are all hiding behind memes and all the interesting things in the internet, you find so many people suffer depression. Because at the end of the day, let's say you've had a stressful day, or a good example, you are jobless. So if you're jobless, so the only thing you'll be doing the whole day literally is using your phone. So you're here looking at people's photos and comparing your life, makes you feel depressed, which is the worst thing you can do to yourself. Then you are here reading memes, you read of funny things, you just laugh about it, and you forget about everything for quite some time. Then reality hits you, like, okay, you're jobless, maybe you don't have money to move around, you don't have maybe money for food. You see, so pole people just suffer depression without knowing. Yeah, and it's not a good thing, like, to always be on your phone. Just spend time with people, like your friends, books, like music, okay, just anything that you like doing, but you reduce your time on your phone. Yes, so I think that's also a thing I can't live without. Yes, because of my businesses, my schoolwork, my work, literally I have to use my phone. Yeah, so that's a major thing. So last but not least is my pocket tissue, wipes, and sanitizer. So majorly tissue, you know, it's just essential, especially if you're a girl, you need to go to the washroom, so you must have pocket tissue. But now the story behind wipes and sanitizer. So honestly, I have an high OCD. I think mine is just on another level. And it all began when, back in the days, like there was too much hijacking when I was young. So like, you know, people used to take money, put it behind. You know what I mean? Like behind. So you put it behind and you go and shit somewhere else, then you pick it and use that money again. So I started this habit of, like, money is so dirty that when I touch money, I have to wipe my hands. If I touch money, I have to wash my hands. Let me tell you, it got into me till today. Like, I literally can't stay without wipes, I can't stay without sanitizer. Because if I touch money, you'll just find me wiping my hands or washing my hands. So it's a major thing to me that I can't live without, honestly. Yeah, and I don't know whether I'm the only one with a high OCD or basically, let me tell you, it's obsessive compulsive disorder. So basically it's having the tendency towards excessive orderliness, perfection, and great attention to detail. That's what it is. So like mine, majorly I notice it's more of contamination, washing, and arrangement. Yeah, so I've talked about the money bit. So when it comes to like arrangement, I like doing things in a weird way. For example, if the pillow is supposed to be straight when I'm making the bed, I don't want to find it in a funny angle. Like, I'll make sure it's just straight. Like, if something is just supposed to be in a certain place, I don't like finding it in a disorganized way. So most of the time, you'll find me just arranging stuff. Or, as I said previously, like if I touch money, or I'll just wash my hands. I just feel like that money is too dirty, or maybe it has too much germs that I have to wash my hands, and it's a bad thing. And I was just reading about it the other day in some books, and I noticed it's something psychological. Like, you see, it just started when I was young because of that story that I've given you, and now I can't stop. Like, it's just gotten into me completely. Yeah, and if you have a high OCD, please comment down below and tell me what's your biggest problem, or how do you deal with it. Yes, so with that said, I hope you enjoyed this video. These were the few things and the most essential things, honestly, I can't live without. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed the video. Stay tuned for more amazing videos. Don't forget the drill: be good, do good. Lots of love, peace, and see you in my next video. Cheers!